Hello everybody, my name is Shauna Kinsler
and I'm Lauren Smith and we're from the Global Green Marketing here in Maynooth, organisation here in Maynooth.
We both specialise in training and management and we're here today to discuss ways in which you can implement green marketing into your business as managers.
So it's important that we get to even just start to know each other just to make it a bit more informal. There's only a few of us here today. So if you could also start off with your first name, where you're from and your favourite pastime even.
Hi, my name is Kira. I'm the manager of the roof. I'm from Leighton and Jewelry.
I'm Amy. I'm the deputy manager of Cosmos. I'm from Dublin and I like playing karaoke.
I am Emma. I'm the human resource manager in the Lighthouse restaurant and I like competing in there.
Perfect. It's really nice to meet you all. Just before we begin, we have a few housekeeping rules. So this lesson today will take around 25 to 30 minutes long. And if you have any questions, just raise your hand and Lauren and I will address them straight away.
Yeah, so I have a handout of the presentation here, just a guide just so you know what we're talking about all the way through the presentation. As I said, 25, 30 minutes long, so you might be feeling less engaged. So here we go, and can everybody hear me? And can everybody see the board correctly?
So, have I got any questions before you begin?
Yeah, go ahead.
Just out of interest, what leads you into green marketing?
Well, I'm sure you're all aware global warming is a massive issue and it's a big concern for everyone in the world today. I just grew writing towards the issue, and when I heard of the organisation here in Maynooth, I just became a member and was on Instagram and trained managers on the issue and obviously see if I can help it in that one.
Yeah, and I myself used to work in a company that didn't adopt the green marketing policy and it wasn't very economically friendly, or just I felt myself personally that it was bad vibes, need something to be done for the environment. So I did a bit of research and looked into what I could do about it, which led me into promotion of green marketing. That's why I'm here talking to you today, and we're off next to give another presentation of a few learning objectives. But at the end of the session, we help you understand the definition of green marketing, understand the importance of green marketing, understand why firms are adopting green marketing, and understand the strategy behind green marketing. So before we start our presentation today, does anybody know what green marketing actually is? Yeah, go ahead.
Green marketing is the marketing of products which are considered not to be harmful for the environment.
Yeah, that's exactly it. You're on the right track there. So the true definition of green marketing is being able to satisfy customers' needs and wants by causing minimal damage to the environment, along with the interest of both the organisation and consumer being protected. And green marketing teaches firms how to use limited natural resources and in a more ethical way, while still allowing the firm to still achieve all its objectives.
Yeah, exactly. So green marketing is the process of selling products and services based on their environmental benefits. So it's way broader than promotion and advertising, which is what a lot of people think it is. It can be used for goods both industrial and consumer, and applies to services too. So obviously yourself as a service at a restaurant. Green marketing activities include four main things. So they're product modification, changes to packaging, changes to production, and changing to advertising.
So, it's going to give an insight to some of the current green marketing consumer activities. So, 8-10% of customers are up to dark green lifestyles. So that means they're composting and they're microgeneration. So, 20-40% of consumers are up for light green changes, which is smaller car, fewer lights. And 60-80% of customers are up for no-brainers, so just turning down thermostats to save energy and at the same time heating bills. So that's the general things that you do in your home, in your business. As I said, turn off the lights before you go to bed, if you're not using them, turn off the teddies, just all switches in general. So most people are doing that, but we want to get up to people composting microgeneration.
Exactly. So here we can see three main green marketing examples. Obviously you'll know who these are straight away, so it makes it easier. Here we can take a look at Starbucks, the worldwide coffee distributor. And they've introduced a reusable cup. So as opposed to just constantly giving out cardboard cups all the time, they allow customers to buy a plastic cup and bring it into the store. and they'll fill their coffee at a discounted price if they see them using this cup. So obviously it's a lot greener. Another massive example here is food, as well as getting again, it's Ben and Jerry's. So obviously they use road, rail, air all the time distributing their goods, which obviously isn't good for the environment. So as a company, they have promised to they promised to purchase renewable energy from a company called Native Energy in America, who specialise in wind and solar. So for every like air mile, road mile they clock or they lodge, they'll buy the renewable energy. Another massive example here is Toyota. They've introduced hybrid cars into their fleet to reduce, you know, emissions of the current cars that they have. But this is an example that will go further into detail later in the lesson.
So, before we can go forward, does anybody know why firms adopt green marketing after what we've already told us? Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I read the recently that FedEx have incorporated green technology in order to reduce emissions and comply with state standards.
Yeah, that's a prime example of exactly why markets adopt green marketing. So another reason why they adopt green marketing could opportunity in social responsibility, which we will go further into detail about in just a few moments. And government pressure and independent pressure is exactly what's happened to FedEx. So firms are realising they are members of the community and must behave ethically. So rising concern on behalf of consumers about the environment is an opportunity for firms to exploit as being environmentally friendly, making it a competitive advantage. So FedEx have seen realised this market and they're now becoming more ethically, because remarketing is coming more wider. So it is important not to jump on a bandwagon to gain market share. Government regulations on things such as waste leave firms with no choice but to be greener.
Now, so as Lauren said, we're going to go into a bit more detail on opportunities and social responsibility. So opportunities, as demands change, many firms see these changes as an opportunity to be exploited and have a competitive advantage over firms marketing non-environmentally responsible alternatives. Some examples of firms who have strived to become more environmentally responsible and attempt to better satisfy customer needs are: one, McDonald's. They replaced its clamshell product packaging with wax paper because of increased concern on behalf of consumers relating to polystyrene production and ozone depletion. So that's a big one with what I was talking to earlier on, is global warming. And then a second example is tuna manufacturers modified their fishing techniques because of the increased concern over drift netting fishing, and which resulted obviously in the death of dolphins.
So the second reason that I spoke about was social responsibility. This is when firms begin to realise that they are members of a wider community and therefore must behave in an environmentally responsible fashion, thus resulting in environmental issues being integrated into the firm's corporate culture. An example of a firm that does not promote its environmental initiatives is Coca-Cola, which invested large sums of money in various recycling activities, as well as having modified their packaging to minimise environmental impacts. Another firm who is very environmentally responsible but does not promote this fact, at least outside of the organisation, is Walt Disney. Walt Disney World, with an extensive waste management programme and infrastructure.
So, green marketing strategy. There are two main aspects that need considering when creating a strategy. So the first is satisfying customer needs and wants with minimal environmental damage. So obviously that's a big one. And then the second one is create perception of quality and commitment to the environment. So within these two aspects, you have to look at products need to have functional and emotional benefits. The spiritual needs of the consumers are affected by environmental issues. And it's important to understand what your consumer green needs are. So obviously don't just push certain things on them if it's not what they actually want, because they'll go against them.
So green marketing strategy. According to Dean and Paquetco, there are five main green marketing strategies. These will be a big value to you as managers to implement into your organisations. So the five are the pure green strategy, the pure green play, sorry. The market green attributes to the consumer. consumer who may be willing to pay more for a lower environmental impact. The second one there is market green status and image, which is a willingness to purchase green products and may be influenced by social status and image. And the third one is self-functional value, targeting a wider audience by promoting function attributes of a product. And the fourth one is target commercial markets. They promote products to commercial and industrial buyers. And lastly, the holistic brand, which is a subtle approach and it's a non-aggressive promotion.
Yeah.
What benefits do these strategies have?
Well, that's actually a really good question. So the benefits of these strategies, the main one is gain consumer trust, which obviously is vital on behalf of managers and companies. So as you can see here, green market strategies to earn consumer trust. So consumers are seeking out greener products currently. They're motivated by the prospects of healthier alternatives, higher quality, preserving the environment and saving time and money. So obviously the big factors and they're hard to, you know, get all in one, but you will eventually. So a company perceived that as committed to sustainability and environmental policies gains the trust of its consumers. Companies in the forefront of corporate greening have many of the following features in place. So a visibly committed CEO, main one, has to happen. Only a chief executive with a clear vision can make environmental integrity a corporate priority and forge an emotional link between a company and its consumers. So the CEO of Timberland, Jeff Schwartz, is a big example. He maintains a high profile as he projects a personal commitment to the environment. So obviously people connect with him on a personal level. Another one is empower employees. Bring employees up to speed about climate change, don't leave them in the dark. Clean technology and green consumer behaviour. Identify ways for your employees to get involved. And be proactive. So it projects leadership and sends a message to investors that risks are minimised. Regulators are less likely to impose restrictions on companies whose actions surpass the minimum standards. So obviously, like, you know, emission taxes, reduce recycle, you'll get grants and stuff for these type of things in a company.
Yeah.
Proactive companies can help identify those standards and discover opportunities for cost effective eco solutions.
So now, taking all the above into consideration, we will look at your own companies and small changes that you can make into anything. So, how do you think you can implement them into your companies?
Well, that kind of reaction from all of you, like, leaving through the doors, and then I'm trying to focus on using social media more and emails.
Yeah, exactly, because more paper that goes out, obviously, it's not good for the environment, but most people are on tech savvy and send an email, so yeah, that would be definitely a good way to implement it.
And what are the main reasons as to why you want to change to a green market? Yeah?
We want to change because it saves money and it's more efficient.
Yeah, perfect, exactly. All your ideas are really, really good. A big one with implementing green strategies are, you know, connecting with your customers. So what you were saying about there, Amy, with social media, that's a really, really good one. It's the biggest platform that we have around. It's very, very cheap and it's cost efficient, so very cheap.
And everybody uses it.
Exactly. You can connect to people straight away in a matter of seconds. It's better than sending out leaflets or letters.
They just get thrown in the bin.
Yeah, exactly.
The compost bin at that, right?
No, you don't use them. Yeah, actually, our compost bin is a really good one. In your restaurants, it's obviously, you know, I can guarantee that 90% of you put all the one rubbish into the one bin. So if you start composting your food, your excess food, one, it'll cut down on waste, and you know these things can be reused elsewhere in your company. So if it can go down into soil, you can put it into your front gardens or, you know, whatever way you want to use. And another massive one is plastic straws. That's been on the news a lot recently, that they're so harmful to the environment and are very, very expensive to buy and make. So as managers in restaurant, I'm sure your main one is satisfying the customer and cost. So if you bring in plastic straws, you're showing the green strategy, you're showing that you've gone green, and it's a lot cheaper to bring them in as well. So as long as I'm going to tell you there, it doesn't come easy. There is challenges that come with implementing green strategies.
Yeah, like every other strategy, green marketing isn't without challenges, as you said. It may be costly to change and product prices may increase, affecting consumer demand. Training staff for the new way of working can be difficult because they have a lack of knowledge. Anything that you implement into a new business is going to be resistant to change. It's always been the way. But green marketing is so environmental, we need to implement it in whether there is change or not. It's not the hardest thing to do, but there will be a challenge. These challenges are normally only short term, but the long term benefits of implementing the green strategy are huge.
Yeah, exactly. So as you can see here, green brands. So, you know, like Starbucks, Ben & Jerry's, these are all associated as being green brands. So green brands are those brands that consumers associate with environmental conservation and sustainable business practices. They appeal to customers who consider sustainability of importance. So if you can offer a product that makes a significant difference, there will be a market segment for you to target. So exactly, your plastic straws is a big one if you went to paper ones. Successful green brands either run on green principles or on alternative technology. For an audience that is becoming more skeptical, it is important to be credible.
With the plastic straws, even if you do have them in your business and they're like McDonald's, they're a big get-go thing, don't have them out for people just to take loads of them. Hand them out in the trays with your consumers. That way, minimize waste and there's only a few being actually given out to customers that they actually need.
Yeah, exactly.
So here we have a video I'm just going to show you. It's about to tell you a case first and then we'll discuss it, okay, after we watch the video.
Yep, so I'm just going to show it to you here now.
California drivers care about the environment, and with commute times increasing, it's more important than ever to make sure we're limiting our emissions and saving on fuel expenses at the same time. That's why Beta Toyota of Sacramento performs a complimentary fuel efficiency evaluation by the Toyota technicians that know your vehicle best. We'll inspect your air filter and your tires for proper wear and inflation. We'll also refill your tires to proper PSI, which also helps to prevent premature tire wear. It's the little things like regular maintenance that can keep your car performing optimally and reduce fuel consumption. If you're looking to trade in your current car for more MPGs, Toyota's lineup of fuel-efficient vehicles are better than ever. Choose from the stylish gas Camry, the even more fuel-efficient Corolla, or the Yaris for optimum commuting fuel efficiency. If you're looking for something for your family road trip, look no further than the Highlander or RAV4, both of which offer great fuel efficiency and boominess to accommodate all your driving needs. Of course, for optimum fuel efficiency, there's always our line of hybrid vehicles, from the Avalon, Prius, and Camry to the Highlander Hybrid or RAV4. We have them all in stock here right now, just in time for road trip season. Stop by or call us today to see how we can help you improve your fuel efficiency and help make California a greener place. California.
So as you can see from Toyota implementing their green strategy into their business, Toyota provides a great example of successful use of green marketing. They position themselves as a global green brand and provide an insight into how sustainability builds a green brand. If products are perceived as less quality, overpriced, and a failure in delivering green benefits, customers will not buy them. So Toyota values and greener practices have influenced their success as one of the largest manufacturers in the whole world.
Exactly. So Toyota are a market leader in the hybrid car industry, like the car I was talking about earlier on in the examples. So in 2011, they sold 3 million Priuses in total. In 2015, they set 6 challenges in relation to their environmental challenge 2050 to improve their relationship with the environment. This included creating a car with zero emissions, producing zero emissions during the product life cycle and at their manufacturing plants.
Yeah, so they also aim to optimize water usage and promote recycling. Their philosophy is known as the Toyota Way. It's a set of principles and behaviors that underline their marginal approach and their production system. This has successfully created perception of quality and commitment in the environment and in consumers' minds, having a positive effect on sales for Toyota.
So, another example of a company that has gone green is Coca-Cola. They have converted from glass bottles, which they brought out when they originally started, to plastic bottles, which are made from 30% plant-based and they're fully recycled. and obviously reusable. I'm sure you see many people walk around with a Coca-Cola bottle with a different drink in it. This helps Coca-Cola attract more customers and conveys a better image for the company. And this change gets across to their customers. They've changed the traditional red background of labelling to green to show the changes that have been made. So obviously green marketing associated with green as opposed to red.
Exactly. So the advantage of green marketing, a company can enter new markets when it brings attention to positive environmental impact. It can gain more profit from green marketing. Green marketing brings a competitive advantage and raise awareness on important environmental and social issues.
Exactly. So now we're just going to do a small, you know, exercise, just keep you engaged. So we're all going to come together and if you all want to brainstorm, just as managers, and think of ways that green marketing can value you and your business as managers. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Phased in. Yeah. Over time.
Yeah.
Yeah,
very good.
Yeah. So have you all got your ideas ready? Yeah. I'll even draw a few of them and the boy can check them out to me, okay?
Yeah, we were saying that it offers a unique product positioning.
Yeah, that's a brilliant one. Offers a unique product positioning, yeah. Any more?
We have attracts new segments of consumers.
Attracts new segments of consumers, that's perfect, yeah. Any more?
We said more product innovations are possible.
More product innovations are possible, that's exactly Sean, have you any more to check them out?
Yeah, so a big one is it enhances your brand. You know, if you're going green, people are gonna notice you more. Starbucks being massive one of those. Environmentally friendly products. So organic products. So if you introduce them, like I was saying, with the compost, you can use that in your restaurant. Becoming more attractive to potential employees, because they want to be part of something positive. So people aren't going to work with a company that aren't going green. Lauren is a prime example of that. She left a company that wasn't going green and now she's doing it herself promoting it. So if you have employees that want to come and work with you, they'll enjoy your job a lot more. And the big one, obviously, because everyone's concerned with money, is competitive advantage within their market. So more employees that are happy, better brand is obviously going to equate to more profits.
To wrap up our presentation today, we define green marketing as the process of selling products and services based on their environmental benefits. The importance of green marketing includes product modification, change to packaging, change in production process, and changing advertising.
Exactly. So today, firms are adopting green marketing, which includes opportunity and social responsibility, which we went into detail with yourselves. Government pressure and competitive pressure. So they're obviously two big ones as well. The rising concern of consumers about the environment is an opportunity for firms such as yourselves to exploit as being environmentally friendly, which may give them a competitive advantage. So obviously the big one for yourselves, the straws, the compost, the working on
being restaurants.
Exactly. So you'll attract more people to your restaurant if they see that you've gone green. As well, to understand the strategy of green marketing is to satisfy consumer needs and wants with minimal environmental damage and create perception of quality and commitment to the environment, as well as Dean and Pacciello's five green marketing strategies.
Yeah, so I just hope that everything that we've brought today, you can implement any of that are more knowledgeable after the presentation today.
Exactly, like the three main examples that we brought, Starbucks, Ben & Jerry's and Toyota.
And they're all worldwide, so
exactly.
They're obviously not doing anything wrong.
No, so they're obviously relatable and we hope that you as managers and as restaurant owners can bring them into your own restaurant. So on behalf of myself and Lauren, We hope that this lesson today has been of benefit to you and it can help you in the future.
And thanks very much for listening.
Thanks.